What's up, Callie?
Happy color.
Jason, I was going to ask you about Tony Brown. I don't know, you closed a lot of officials now that he passed away yesterday.
Yeah, so sad. Our prayers go out to, his family. What an incredible guy. No matter how you look at him as a referee, but just a great human being. He'll be missed. It's funny, I got a chance to talk to him. Daryl Armstrong called, FaceTimed him while we were at the Notre Dame game. And his spirits, he was in good spirits. And we were, joking with him. And that was the last time I got to talk to him and see him. And so it just shows how life can be fragile. And so, again, our prayers go out to his family.
I was going to ask you also about Mutombo. I know you played with him in New Jersey. You got diagnosed with the brain tumor.
Yeah, I hope the treatments go well. Again, we're praying for a speedy recovery and that things go well for him.
Jason, you mentioned before the last game that you've thrown a lot at guys like Christian Wood and you guys defensively.
Yeah.
Those schemes and stuff. Yeah. After seeing one game in action, how do you feel like they're picking up as far as the new guys?
Yeah, the new guy, Seawood, is doing great. Again, at the first game, we got to watch a little film here and see the mistakes that we made. And so not just the new guys didn't make all the mistakes. It was a team effort in our transition game. We have to do better in being able to declare the ball. Again, Phoenix took advantage of that with our transition defense not being up to par. And then rebounding the ball, they're late. They won every 50-50 ball. So that's what we actually take pride in, of winning the 50-50 balls. And we came up short in that fourth quarter. So we have to improve there. But Seawood and the guys that are new, Capazzo, those guys are doing great. Game one, there's going to be some mistakes. We'll learn from it, and hopefully we can be better tomorrow.
What did you tell Christian Wood after his stellar performance the other night?
Yeah, I thought he did great. Yeah, he let the game come to him, and he was Seawood. Again, we're asking him to do a lot, not just on the offensive end, but the defensive end. Again, knocking down the threes to keep us going there in that third, it was big for us. And then when you look at defensively, I thought he did a really good job.
Without revealing any game plans, how do you contain a guy like Ja Morant?
Yeah, he's special. Ja puts a lot of pressure on your defense. In understanding, you got to take care of the ball or they're going to score. They're one of the fastest teams in the league. And again, all eyes will be on him. We got to figure out how to slow him down. But again, he's an all-star. He's talked about winning MVP. He has a really good team. He has a great coach over there. So, again, we got to try to make it tough on him.
What were your thoughts when he came out and said that he has one of his individual goals to win MVP?
Yeah, he has the ability and the team to do that. It's about winning, and he's all about winning. When you see someone like that win most improved and he felt his teammates should have gotten that award, that's who Ja is. It's about team. It's about winning. And if his team is in a position like they were last year, he'll be in that conversation for MVP.
When you look at guys like him and Luka, two guys who kind of have the same job description in running a team, is it kind of interesting that they go about it in such different ways?
Yeah, I think the one way they go about it is that it's all about winning. And so the best players in this league are about winning. Ja's about winning, making plays, not just offensively, but we've seen the highlights of coming up with steals or block shots, and so he can do it defensively too. So, just understanding that Ja's one that wants to win and is going to do whatever it takes to help his team win.
Jason.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry. We talked, I guess, before the game on Wednesday about experimenting with different rotations and combinations and the closing lineup. How do you decide, which combination to go with first? How do you just kind of pick a starting point, if you will?
Yeah, I think you go with the ones who've been through it. Game one, game five could be different. But as a staff, we'll talk about it well before the game of who we're going to end with down the stretch, close or blowout. So we have two groups that, if there's a blowout, that will finish the game. And then if it's a close game, who we're going to go with the last 3 minutes, the last 6 minutes, and so we've already scripted that. There's always change of who's going and who's not going, in the sense of who's shooting the ball well or who has the hot hand, but also who's participating on the defensive end too. And so you can always know if the game is tight, 77 will be in the game, and then you work the other four around them. You can look at it both ways. It could be an offensive group, as long as you can get the subs in to play defense. But we feel that we have a group that can play defense and offense. When you look at that group that ended the game with Maxi out there, being able to space the floor and knock down shots, and then being one of our best defenders on the floor. And then looking at Seawood here as we go forward, having Seawood, you know, be able to finish games too.
Dwight Powell played in all 100 games last year. He didn't play the other night. Was it one of those situations where the players in front of him were playing well?
Yeah, you look at the depth chart, the roster, it's big heavy. So he just has to be patient. He's a pro, and he'll get his opportunity.
And to go off of the closing lineups too, when you're experimenting, do you try and, like, every game try and get different data points on different combinations, or do you approach it more of like giving stretches, like, if you will? Of,
yeah, we'll look at a 10-game stretch maybe. Okay. You know, you can't do two games and then figure like that's the way we're going to roll. I don't think you get enough data. So we'll look at trying to, you know, look at, you know, multiple games if we can get to 5 to 10 to be able to look at who's had success combination-wise. Again, I thought the group who finished had a great defensive stand. Lee makes a tough shot. And then the group that was in offensively, because we didn't have a timeout, understood exactly what we had to do. We just didn't give the right space in there at the end.
Do you coach rotations? Do they tend to be more scripted early in the season and more coached by feel later in the season once you have a feel?
They're scripted throughout the year.
Yeah.
And so The things are already planned out. It's just the feel comes in of who's going, what matchups are helping or hurting us, and so we'll make that adjustment as we go.
Are they scripted for situations like foul trouble? You know, for example, Spencer in the third quarter.
Foul trouble is the fluid. Like, you have to make the adjustment. When you look at foul trouble, is always something, injury, someone struggling that you need to get out a little bit sooner than normal. Those are all on the table as you watch the game.
Any chance the scripted rotation has 15 players in it for the home game tomorrow?
We don't know about that. We haven't had a chance to talk about that, so I don't think that's going to happen tomorrow.
Besides Ja, who among some other Grizzlies that's a concern for you tomorrow?
Their whole team. They play hard. You look at Bain and what he's done. They're doing this with Al Jackson and Brooks in the lineup. Brooks could be back tonight or for tomorrow. So Taylor is one of the best coaches in this league. And you look at their group, they play hard for one another. They play as a team, and that's dangerous. As much as you talk about Ja, they got other guys that can hurt you.
Jason, is there a emphasis from the league this year about delay of game? Luka's got caught a couple of times throwing the ball.
Yeah, it's something that the league has talked about. It's a judgment call, I suppose, by the referees. So Luka's been called a couple times here, and so we just have to make that adjustment.
Did the league rescind his tech because he said he was just passing the ball to the referee?
Yeah, that you would have to ask management. I don't know if they rescinded it or not.
Kind of a broad question for you: the Rangers just hired a new manager, Bruce Bochy, today.
Yes.
The Giants.
Yep.
Different sport, but leading an organization in this city.
Yeah, I think, I think Texas has a great manager in Bruce. I think when you look at being a coach here, they expect winning, but they also, you know, like to see, you know, people be held accountable but have fun. And so you look at the Cowboys, the Rangers in here with the Mavs, it's about winning, but it's about, you know, being able to have fun, and when you look at what the Cowboys have done this season, everyone's enjoying watching them play. But it's about team, And I think the Rangers have that as they build a contender.
Speaking of the Cowboys, how do you think Dak's going to do Sunday, his first game back?
I hope he does great. I know that they're happy to have him back, but it just shows the depth of the Cowboys being there, have their backup step in and hold it down until Dak got back. So I'm excited to see Dak play. They got both sides of the ball is very, very good when you look at their defense. And then now getting Dak back, that helps them.
Hey, all right. Jason, you're bringing back and the
anything
the
else sport? About any other sport?
Non-football, non-baseball. Right.
They're good.
Right.
You bring back the J-Kid for the WIN program.
Yeah.
The donations, just talk about how important it is for you to give back to the community.
Yeah, I think we started that last year, and the team took off. We raised a lot of money for the community. And so we look forward to doing it again and raising a lot of money. We should have had one the other night, but we have the opportunity tomorrow to get a W. But it's always good to be able to help the community here in Dallas.
It's just a home win, though, isn't it?
You wanted all the wins. Last year you wanted me to go back for all the wins we had.
Oh, yeah, that is true. My bad.
He's good at
spending other people's money.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. Oh, now you forgot.
I'm surprised you remember that.
Oh, I don't forget.
What'd you guys see on film there? Just watch the film?
Yeah.
What'd you see? As opposed to last
that's,
game?
That's team thing. That's not me thing. Yeah. So we'll keep it in the team.
What are you looking forward to tomorrow night going against one of the other top players in the league, in Ja Morant?
It's just another game. You know, we can improve from the first game. Whatever we didn't do right, which is a lot of things. And, you know, it's always good to go against players like that. You know, it's fun. It's fun for the fans. And I think they will join the game.
How would you describe him and his game?
Shit, I don't know. I mean, he can do everything, you know. Obviously, he's one of the fastest guys out there. But since the first year, you know, he improved a lot. His shooting, his playmaking. So he's a really complete player, and it's going to be really hard to stop him.
Could have been describing yourself there.
No, not fast. I'm not fast.
You both have been talked about a lot as far as the MVP. Of course, Ja came out this week and said that's one of his individual goals. What do you think of his play the other night? And conducting himself like an MVP
type of
player?
I mean, yeah, for sure. I just told you what kind of player he is, so for sure he is.
Luka, I know the first game didn't finish the way you wanted, but did you see something and feel something that you're like, okay, I see how this could be a great season, we can build upon what we did in the first game?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I think the way we played the first half and a part of fourth quarter, I think we can be great this season. You know, obviously, it was the first game, you know, we got a couple of new guys, but we got to work on it and be better than that. But I feel really confident in this team.
Look at what you
guys was Christian. I mean, I think a lot of Mavs fans heard that he could be good and then saw just how good he. I mean, what do you like about him from what you've seen in practices and then what do you think he can be like for this organization?
Yeah, very important. I mean, you all saw it, how he can play, he can contribute to this team a lot. So we're really happy to have him.
With Ja, I know in the media from the outside, there's a lot of comparisons, you know, whether it's you or other players that kind of get grouped together in rivalries. Do you feel that internally, or do you, you know, does that resonate at all in terms of like motivation or just how, you know, certain players approach certain games, if that makes sense?
I mean, probably some players do. I don't. I mean, it's every game is really important. I think the West is stacked, so every game is going to matter to get in the playoffs, so you got to be ready and go 100% for every game. I mean, yeah, fine. It's been a long time. We only had one preseason game there. But, you know, this season, it's a new season. It's not preseason no more, so I'm really excited to see the fans.
Do you feel like some of what we saw the other night is the fact that you only had three preseason games?
No.
Luka, you mentioned the new guys. Do you feel like y'all are making more strides offensively or defensively? Where do you feel like more work needs to be put in?
Both, always. We got to work on defense and offense. You're going to win with both. So we got to work on both, like I said. We got a couple of new guys, but we got a lot of work on. That's why it's 82 games. So we got 81 to go.
How much does it help to have a guy like JaVale, who's been with winning teams, to help maybe some of those younger guys too come along?
Yeah, it's very important. You know, he's a vet in this team. I mean, this league. He's won 2-3 championships, and he's gonna help not just the young guys, but everybody around.
Perfect at the free throw line the other night. I know that's something that you've worked on. Is there a certain percentage that you're trying to shoot for this year?
Trying to make them. That's it.
What's so special about the preseason for Curlers and you being dubbed as a favorite to win MVP? Given that what's so special about that MVP?
I mean, it's probably people believe you can win MVP. You know, that's a good thing. Like I say, you know, first of all, you gotta win games just to be in consideration for MVP. So first of all, we gotta win games.
Luca, this is kind of a little off topic, but I know St. Jean came to Slovenia this summer. What were your best memories, or what were the highlights of that trip and getting to have him out there with you?
I mean, he was, what, about 1 week he was there. You know, he was really into, he helped a lot of coaches in Slovenia. He played poker with us, but he lost. Of course,
right.
I took his money. You can ask him. But no, he was good. He helped a lot, especially Slovenian coaches. You know, NBA is a little bit, it's a big difference than national teams. And we're really happy to have him there for 1 week. I think he's coming back next season, hopefully, if we qualify.
With the poker, was it players, teammates, coaches? Who were you going against?
It was players, and him.
Okay.
But he lost.
How much money?
I don't. $10.
Sure.
You mentioned you're excited to play in front of the fans tomorrow. Any message for them heading into the game?
I mean, I'm just really excited. You know, hopefully it's gonna be full. But no message. Every year the same message. You know, we're gonna try to win a championship. Last year, especially in the playoffs, was amazing. The atmosphere was one of the best I ever been in, and it was just, I was happy to play home.
Luca, when Spencer's in there in the game with you, how does he make things easy?
I mean, he can do a lot of things, you know, and he can shoot, he can pass, he can organize a team, and I think his role is going to become bigger and bigger.
With Spencer, Nico said this summer that Spencer's parents told him they've never seen Spencer happier in his career. Do you have a story or an example of when you've noticed Spencer being particularly happy to be part of this team?
I mean, yeah, every time he hangs out with me. You ask him, he's going to say the same thing.
Why not?
Of course. You know, I've asked a few players in the league, and obviously teammates think highly of your first shooter. So I've asked a few guys that have worn your shoe in the past couple of days, and they love it. To see players across the league embrace your shoe, because, you know, that's a competitive thing behind that. What do you think about that?
Yeah, it's amazing. It's unbelievable, you know. I saw Obi wearing them first game. It's just a pleasure, you know. But I don't blame him. It's a great shoe, you know.
Thank you.
Thank you.